Hey everyone, and welcome to my reaction to the series premiere of The Fall of the House of Usher. This is Lazy Cat Reactions. I hope you will enjoy my response to this show. I have been excited to do this ever since I found out about it. By the time this goes up, there will only be one other Mike Flanagan show on my channel that you can check out, and that is Midnight Mass. If I remember, I will try to link it in the outro. I also did react to the teaser trailer that they released. It was like 15 seconds, and so I talked a little bit there, but in case anyone missed that, I personally am kind of like a casual Poe fan. I like Poe. I like the stories. I don't know all of them. Like, I know The Telltale Heart. I know The Raven. I think I know a couple more. Mask of the Red Death, I know that one too. But The House of Usher, The Fall of the House of Usher, that one I don't. Funny story though. When I was in junior high or high school, I forget when we read them, but I know I was a teen. Some friends of mine who were in the PATS program, which is the one for the smart kids, so the ones who basically were looked at as regular kids and the rest of us were looked down upon. Some of my friends who were in that program made like their own little class project film of Fall of House of Usher. I don't think they ever showed it to me. No, they didn't. I don't know if I asked. I might have asked. And they just didn't show it. But anyways, you know, so I don't know, like, obviously, with it being their class, like, if they'd had what they were assigned to do with it. But yeah, they made, like a film, their own school production of Fall of the House of Usher to turn in, I should say. So that's really all I know about it, about that particular one, is my friends doing this little class film for it. A lot of people like Mike Flanagan. A lot of people say he's like the best in horror. And as I said, I only know him from Midnight Mass. And yeah, he was pretty good with that. So I'm definitely looking forward to this. Hopefully, you know, after I finish this, hopefully some point in 2024, I will get to Hill House and Bly Manor and maybe some of the others that he's done. I think he did The Midnight Club, maybe. So hopefully I will get to those. But at the time of recording, the only other Mike Flanagan that I have done is Midnight Mass. This episode is titled A Midnight Dreary. As I wander, weak and weary. A wealthy CEO faces a criminal investigation amid tragedy, trauma, and a supernatural threat. The Usher family learns an informant lurks among them. Let me know how you got excited about this. Were you a Poe fan? Were you Mike Flanagan? Were you a fan of some of the cast? You know, maybe a certain actor or so in it? Did it just look good for you? Let me know. My cats are deciding to fight, so you will get the amusement of hearing that. But I am excited for The Fall of the House of Usher. I hope you are excited to join me as I react to it. Let's get started. Sex, smoking, substance, suicide, and violence. Got it all. My kind of show. Some scenes of a strobing effect may affect very sensitive viewers, so be warned. Ooh. So New Year's, a dungeon, crow, or raven.
Ooh.
Three people.
And the fever called living is conquered at last. be silent in that solitude. Would you?
So is this all like a flashback?
We stand on the brink of a precipice.
Peer into the abyss.
What is it? Ravenmask. And she's here. Our first impulse is to shrink from the danger.
Lenore?
Unaccountable.
Is it Lenore?
Oh, that's right. She's an even tougher get than me. Have you ever had her on the record? I don't think you have.
Hey, bud.
Never had either of us on the record.
This is Assistant U.S. Attorney C.A. Dupin sitting with Roderick Usher. November 20th, 2023. Mr. Usher has waived his right
to have a telegram. This is in the future. Cool.
And Mr. Dupin has waived the glass of Henry the Fourth, so which of us is crazier?
Just warming it up.
This is indeed Roderick Usher. In this very room.
Yeah, so I'm guessing most of this is a flashback.
You cannot understand the things I've done unless you understand the life that Madeline and I were born into.
70 years? Jeez.
And the woman who would shape every choice we'd
ever made. And Beth Gish.
Our mother. Eliza. It was one of our mother's most insistent rules. So
she's having an affair.
Madeline insisted that we break it.
She's having an affair. That's why she's on there. Oh, that was brilliant.
We think maybe.
Move mountains, talk anyone into anything. You're the smartest man she ever met. We're here to ask you.
Suck up.
Maybe you have an idea. Maybe you could talk her into it.
I'm sorry. You're here at my home.
Doctors still embalm her.
They can't.
I know.
Why?
So what do we do?
Because it's the start of the story.
I'm supposed to, because she's here.
I'm not going to turn around, Roger.
That's fine.
It's fine with me.
You don't have to.
So why are you telling me this?
But if she is there, he's going to get a shock later.
Kids. You always were an effective orator, Huggy. Even your opening arguments, I was impressed. I watched that tape back a few times. That may have been the last time, you know.
The last time you were impressed.
It was the last time we were all together. That day was the last day we were all in the same place.
Okay.
But when they hear
Madeline's
something
like
else too, something they don't expect. And the reason why this trial's going to have a different outcome. You're going to hear from one of them. An informant from within the inner circle, someone so close to the Spanish
crimes,
their testimony and evidence will be unimpeachable.
Objection.
Approach.
Kid likes it.
Holy fuck, this is bad.
Is there a bowling alley? That's cool.
Dad doesn't do family dinners. This is about one thing. The mole.
Informant. A mole is one of them who infiltrated us, and an informant is one of us giving something to them.
Okay, so a mole is like Leonardo DiCaprio.
You don't think you'd do that, do you?
We have $1 billion and an endless supply of test monkeys to be successful. Just
You know, I do not support testing on animals. That's not.
Sorry, Dr. Reed, but you have to come.
You absolutely cannot come.
I'd like to be your valet.
But there's a whole process for that. The significant others are a thing.
So I've got at least two gay couples.
Well, you let me move
that, but you won't let me.
That's right. I don't know what time.
Front facing stuff, softballs at Fox. Hannah knows which size the dick's buttered on. He'll be friendly. Tucker? I'm sorry, you just threw up my mouth a little bit. Yes, call Bresnigan at Vanity Fair, see if he wants a profile.
Okay, you know which way these guys lean.
Change. Talk about his Jordans and his charity work. Kimmel, Colbert, also Leo, and fuck it. Fine, Victorine as well. Victorine over for Vanity and Cosmo. For some reason, people like her.
Your step thing.
What if he's even
worse? The last time I saw them all together. I saw them the last time I saw them alive.
What if he's the informant and he's doing this to, you know, throw them off?
Well, because of the informant thing that all of this happened, if you're somehow implying that I'm responsible, even indirect.
I know who's responsible.
You know who's responsible. For...
That's him. Is this woman he sees supposed to be her? A younger version of her? Like a special mod or something?
We're sitting outside of time and space.
We buried three of my children today. The other three last week.
I know.
All six of them dead.
And said, I'm sorry.
There's a reason I'm telling you this. My mother, my children, New Year's Eve. You'll be reluctant to accept it or believe it, but I promise you, every single piece is important.
Okay.
We buried my boy today. And almost nobody came this time. Sixth coffin I've put in the dirt. In less than 2 weeks.
The boundaries which divide life from death are, at best, shadowy and vague. Who shall say?
Right. Who is she?
Where the one ends and where the other begins. We stand.
She's like a prophet or something.
Horror.
So why is his wife sitting in a separate location? Why is she not sitting with him?
It is merely the idea of oneness, rushing annihilation.
So Lenore's still alive.
That it involves that one most ghastly and lonesome of all the most ghastly and lonesome images of death and suffering and desire.
So is that the Lenore from Raven, or maybe that Lenore is separate? You know, like maybe she's named after someone? Maybe that Lenore is named after someone, which, because, you know, obviously with the Raven, Lenore's dead. So, Lenore could be, that could be the name of, you know, like, her grandmother. Ooh. So, that is a really great start. Lots of questions, as we should have. And it's looking like, well, he says he has six kids, and obviously he buried the six kids. So, are they all informants? Or did something else happen? There's a part of me that thinks the twist is going to be that he's the informant. He was doing that because he wanted to do maybe like a loyalty test or something to see which of his kids was actually loyal. Or maybe it's Madeline. I gotta look up some of these actors because, like I said, that one guy with the beard, I'm pretty sure he was the Muslim cop in Midnight Mass. And like I said, Katie Siegel, she was in Midnight Mass. I'd seen her in other things too. I think she was in that movie Hush. And I missed her name, but the one whose actress is like Samantha Sloyan or something, who of course was the bitch in Midnight Mass. See, most of them I recognize from Midnight Mass, and I know the actors have a tendency to work with Mike Flanagan over and over. Much, as I said, like Tim Burton with Johnny Depp and Helena Bonham Carter. They tend to work together a lot. Because I saw with Midnight Mass, some of them like Annabeth Gish and Katie Siegel, that they had also been in Hill House and I think Bly Manor and possibly some of the others. So, mystery, intrigue. They've obviously set the stage, so it's all a flashback, like, whew. You know, and when I go through, like I said, I love that they're titles of Poe's stories. I've got The Telltale Heart, The Pit and the Pendulum, and of course the final one is The Raven. I don't have a lot to say because I'm still taking it and processing it. I'm going to start episode 2 here in a few minutes. I said I was hungry, so I might grab something to eat, maybe. Or I might just wait, because it's almost lunchtime, too. But I'm going to start episode 2 here shortly. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments, what you thought regarding the first episode. We will only, of course, keep it to the episodes that I'm reacting to. So obviously, with this being episode 1, we're only going to talk about episode 1. When we're on, say, episode 5, we can talk about those 5, you know. But we want to keep it with what's going on, and we don't want any spoilers. I'm sure you guys already know this, but I feel like it needs to be said because someone might accidentally share something. By the time this airs, I mean, I'm sure probably everyone who's watching the reactions has seen the show, but you never know. There might be someone who hasn't and is watching it for the first time. It happens. There goes my stomach. But let me know your thoughts down in the comments regarding the episode, how you know Mike Flanagan, if you're watching it because of Mike Flanagan, if you're a Poe person, you know, let's get a conversation going. I hope you enjoyed my reaction to episode 1. I'm definitely excited. I cannot wait. Like I said, I'd heard that they were doing this, I think I heard last year that they were doing it, which was the same, I think I heard right after I did Midnight Mass. So, I was very excited to hear about it. And I know Midnight Mass has Hamish Linklater, which I'm kind of surprised he's not in this, considering he was in that. But you can catch him in my reactions to Tell Me Your Secrets, which may or may not be up on the channel by the time this airs. If not, then keep your eye out, because I plan to have it go up in fall of 2024. And then depending on when this is, you know, if this airs before it, just keep your eye out for that with Hamish, a.k.a. Father Paul. I'm excited. I can't wait to start episode 2. I hope you enjoyed my cats kind of mixing it up a little bit. I'll see you for episode 2 next time. If you can, please click the link in the description to support me and buy me a coffee. My editor's link is also there, so if you are interested in an editor for your channel or for whatever else, please give her a look. I'll see you for episode 2. Take care. Bye.